Okay, it's August 19th, 2017. It's 10:15 a.m. and we're draining the pool, or I'm draining the pool again. We're gonna fill it up again too, by the way. We were gonna like go for the season, but I gently insist this is 6,000 of water that you can have as a supply, especially with what's coming on the 21st. The eclipse, you don't know what to expect. There's a lot of stupid in this country. And that stupid can really mess up a lot of things. So we're gonna, after it drains down, we're gonna go get some things at the store. I hate spending what little bit of money we have, but you know, $20 or so, and buy a few things. These things are draining out from down here. I got two different hoses. This is 6,400 gallons when it's totally full. But when we fill it, it'll probably be close to 6,100 gallons, roughly. At least 6,000 gallons of water. Even if it's treated with chlorine and such, it can still be boiled and get that chlorine out of it. But people don't think of things sometimes like that, maybe. If you have a swimming pool, you've got a reservoir. You have a tank of water. So this is an old pool. It's 4 years old. And now I see why people change pools, because, I mean, this thing is just, it's got places in the bottom where it's got like a little small holes that's just seeping out. But it won't seep out like for like a month or two, or not even that, for probably about a year before it would seep all the way out, but just a slight little hole. But it just gets all this algae in it right away within about 2 weeks, 3 weeks. This is what it looks like. This has only been like 3 weeks that we've taken the pump off. One of the pumps not off, but we stopped it because you don't run it unless the water's going up in the pump. So, and we had frogs out here last night screwing around, I guess. There's probably eggs in here that are all going to go. We've had that in the past. Help save the tadpoles and whatnot. But we can't do that no more. So this will be filled up here. Let's see, it's 10:20 roughly. Probably about 3 o'clock this afternoon, we'll be out here cleaning and filling it back up. So, yeah, if we have just one hole filling it up, we'll probably might let it run overnight. It won't overflow or anything like that. So, an idea for some people, if you have a swimming pool, even a small one, you know, that's a reservoir for you. That's a water tank if you need for emergency water. This right here, even it being dirty, you could boil this. If you had to drink, filter it with like cloth. They say cheesecloth, which everybody has, right? But I've got a big Berkey water filter. I've got two filters in there, and I bought two more. The two filters I have in there has got enough for another, I'd say a year roughly on just those two. But I went ahead and bought two more for an emergency also, so it filters the water. It filters out 99.99% of anything, including the groundwater with all this Monsanto crap with the chemicals they spray on all this. It does filter out about 97-98% of that. So it's kind of like you're stuck either way, but better than what most people have. So, but you can boil water like this and let it cool and drink it. You could use this if you had to wash up a little bit. You know, still, I would still rather boil stuff, make it cleaner than that. But you can use the water for that. You have a bucket of this to wash clothes, wash dishes if you had to, you know, just all kinds of things. But you need water, you know, and fire. I've got fire starters and stuff all over the place in little jars from like pepper, grind pepper, black pepper and such. Cotton balls with petroleum jelly, i.e. Vaseline. And they're real, real good fire starters, and they work. And then I have, not fire starters, those are cotton balls, those are kindling. But, or, you know, they're fire starters. But I have the sticks too, so, and that's about it for now.